This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. The first 1,000 people to sign up using the link in the description will get their first 2 months free. We've all been there, at least those of us who are the proud owner of testicles. Whether it's a purposeful strike to the balls from an attacker or a stray tennis ball getting you in the sweet spot, you know that it can cause excruciating pain that can leave you on the floor. In worst cases, it can actually do a fair bit of damage or at least make you throw up. According to Snopes, who asked the question, is it possible to kill a man with a swift kick to the groin? The answer is no. Getting a blow to the privates, gonads, nuts, stones, bollocks, there are more terms, won't be the end of you. But let's find out why it's so painful in this episode of the Infographics Show. Why does it hurt so much to get kicked in the testicles? Okay, so let's just clear up a few things first. We know we said you couldn't die from getting kicked in the ding-dangs, but there is some literature in Germany from the 19th century that said a custom used to exist in which quarreling men would basically squeeze each other's balls. It was written that in one case, a man was seized with violent convulsions and died in a few minutes. There have been a few very rare cases in recent times when someone died after taking a hit, but there was always a secondary cause as to why they died. So it's not going to kill you or make you stronger, but it will hurt like hell. Why? These sperm factories and testosterone makers are a man's crown jewels. But unlike the real crown jewels, they are not exactly heavily fortified. They hang outside your body and are not surrounded by bone or muscle as other important organs are. It's almost as if nature gave men an Achilles heel, except put it right under their body's piece de resistance, their highly valued penis. Your junk, of course, is your most valued treasure, because without them, you wouldn't be able to procreate. In the cold eyes of Mother Nature, that's the only reason you exist. For that reason, there are lots of nerves around your cojones, so you will take better care of them. Pain, to some extent, is our friend. It helps us to take care of ourselves. People who feel no pain, those suffering from the very rare condition of congenital analgesia, often die young and live miserable lives. So look on the bright side, your sensitivity is good for you. Another good thing is the fact that the large number of sensory nerve endings means it can feel quite nice having them touched. Squeezing, though, might be a bit much for some people. There is another reason why nature put these highly sensitive organs on the outside, and that is because sperm likes a nice climate. If it was too hot or too cold, the sperm would die before it could get to its destination, the female reproductive tract. Your body is amazing. It regulates the temperature of the balls using the cremasteric muscle to pull them up to the body when conditions are too chilly and letting them dangle down on a toasty day. Your lucky balls have year-round climate control. When you get hit in these glands, as we said, there is nothing to protect them. They are so soft they can absorb much of the blow, which would be much better than if you could actually break your balls. But how does the pain manifest? As you boys and men will know, it doesn't just stay down there in those little sacks. The pain moves into your stomach, which is what we call referred pain. The feeling travels like a little pain train up through the perineal and pudendal nerves, and that train's destination is all the way to the groin, the abdomen, up the spine, and sometimes with a last stop at the buttocks. The stomach plays an important part, as your rhesus pieces actually developed near to your kidneys, and from there they moved down until they reached your ball sack. On the way, they got connected with lots of nerves, which make up your spermatic plexus. For this reason, getting a direct shot to your walnuts can make you feel nauseous or actually make you puke. One doctor described it like this: it's due to the vagal reflex, in which a nerve signal from your testicles travels up your spinal cord and brainstem and activates the nausea and vomiting centers in your brain. He went as far to say that this has another evolutionary purpose, and that is, if you're sick, you will give up the fight and no more damage will be done. He gives the example of animals of the same species getting into a scrap. Often, if the testicles are hurt, the victim gives up and the aggressor moves off. Humans, though, can sometimes be a little more barbaric. So what else can we expect when we get hit in our plums? Well, the pain should last anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes, and as you know, there's not much you can do about it. But it can be worse. You might just get a bit of bruising, which can be managed with some ice. You might also hit them so hard that you get something called trauma-induced testicular torsion. That doesn't sound good, and it isn't. We found a research paper that told the story of a 14-year-old boy that did a somersault off a springboard and hit the water bobbles first. His pain didn't go away, and he was taken to the ER, where he was diagnosed with a traumatic scrotal hematoma, or blood forming outside the blood vessels. But the pain and swelling just kept getting worse, even with pain medications. He ended up going back to the hospital 5 days later, and it was discovered that one of his testicles was gangrenous. He had immediate surgery and kept the injured apricot. You could also rupture your apples, which basically means you tear them on the inside and the testicular contents get spilled. This can be very painful and usually only happens after extreme trauma, such as your bangers hitting the gear stick of your car as you smash into a tree at speed. You'll need an ultrasound to see if you've ruptured them. The rare outcome is you lose one or both balls, but the testes or testis can be salvageable, although your ghoulies might not be quite as good at making semen as they used to be. The good news is that 90% of these ruptures lead to a full recovery and a working set of healthy nuts. There's another thing we should talk about, and that's the missing bean. This is what one person wrote on Reddit when the topic of worst testicle hit was raised. Riding a bicycle in the rain, feet slip off the pedals, I land on the crossbar, and one of my nuts ends up inside me. What happened to him was he suffered a testicular dislocation, wherein a lone marble can get hit so hard that it ends up going into your abdomen or even close to the pubic bone over the penis. According to one health site, indeed, this often happens when riders of bicycles or motorbikes hit their nads on the frame or gas tank. It is rare, but it does happen, and you'll need surgery and a bit of testicular repositioning if you want your egg to keep working. We hate to tell you this, but there's also something called being degloved, which is your scrotum just being torn right off. But we're talking about hits today, and it's not likely you'll get degloved from a blunt force trauma unless you're involved in some kind of vicious accident. The rule of thumb is that if your pain doesn't go away in, say, 20 minutes, you might want to get your testicles looked at. Also, if you start peeing blood after the hit, of course, get that checked out. Taking a swift kick to the unmentionables is no fun and can be really, really painful. Thankfully, Skillshare offers hundreds of courses to help you feel better right now. From massage remedies to herbal recipes to help soothe pain, try out a class on Skillshare today and start feeling better right away. You can learn this and many more things by joining Skillshare. Premium membership will give you unlimited access to topics that will improve your skills and your life. The first 1,000 people to sign up by visiting skillshare.com/infographics34 or by clicking the link in the description will receive 2 months of Skillshare absolutely free. Join Skillshare and start learning today. Over to you now. Tell us about the worst time you were hit in the testicles. How did it happen? And was it over quickly, or did you get one of those types of more severe injuries? Also, do you know how many terms we used for testicles in this story? Let us know in the comments. Be sure to check out our other video called Most Painful Things a Person Can Experience. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.